What's going on, everybody? I hope you're having a good day. There's been some breaking news. It's going to be everywhere today. It's indictments on 13 Russians. The news is going to act like it's a major, 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 major deal. They're going to run away with a narrative. They're going to say all these things, but they're probably not going to tell you the true, unfettered truth about what this means and what actually happened. So I'm here to do that. And whether you're left-leaning or right-leaning, I got the truth for you. I got an accurate depiction of what's going on. So let's wait about 30 seconds for everybody to get into the live stream, and I want to talk about the 13 indictments that have been placed today, what it means, why they were indicted, what it means for the future, what it means for the present, how it actually influenced the election, and that's what it is. So let's wait about 20-30 seconds. I appreciate you guys for joining. As always, if you would like, you can follow me on Instagram at DreamRare, DreamRare. You can follow me on Twitter at Legendary Energy. Check out my website, legendary.vision, and check out the comment section below. I will post a link to my email list. It's free, and it takes about 10 seconds, 5 seconds to sign up for my email list. So let's wait 20 more seconds for people to get in. There's been indictments today. That's the big word that the media uses. It's indictments, indictments. Russia, 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 indictments, Facebook, Russia, collusion, Russia, Mueller, Russia, indictments, Russia. And there's a lot of, you know, narrative pushing from both sides, for sure, for sure. But I want to talk about this especially now. I just want to wait about 10, 15 more seconds. I know there's a lot more people going to come in, so I'd rather wait. But so the big breaking story today, as I said, and I'll continue to say, 13 Russian nationals have been indicted for influencing the election. What does this mean? Let's start with Russian nationals and what that means. So to start, these are just Russians. These are people from Russia. There's no indication that they worked for the government. There's no indication that they worked for the Kremlin. There's no indication that they're any sort of, you know, negative, nasty force trying to destroy America. They're simply Russian human beings who were posting advertisements and posting influence, having opinions on the United States election and getting involved and, you know, trying to, you know, be part of the 2018 election. So that's the first thing that jumped out to me that the media is not going to say, because they have a label for everything. You know, they want to, you're this, you're a minority, you're black, you're white, you're Latino, you're Mexican, even though, you know, no other type of Latino exists. Everybody's Mexican. You know, you're this, you're that, you're a nationalist, you're blah, you're that. That's what they do. And they call them Russian nationals. They're national, national. It simply means they're from Russia. I mean, nothing further, nothing less. There's no indication, there's no reports that any of this influence came from the government themselves. They're telling you that they're just Russians. So before I even get into what all this means, that's the first thing that jumped out to me. So they're not even working with the Russian government. They're just Russians posting on Facebook and Twitter. Whoa, crazy. I know. Second thing, they were posting a bunch of ads in a bunch of different directions. So the way the media wants to portray this and does portray this is that Russians were stirring up the U.S. election. They're trying to sow division in the United States society. You know, that's what they're doing with all of these ads. So what exactly did the ads say? They were all sorts of ads. So all of the Russians, I won't say right because they were Russian, but the Russian advertisements and the Russian Facebook posts and the Russian Twitter posts, they were literally everything. They went from a Twitter account that was posing as a GOP Tennessee, and they were posting a bunch of clips that pretty much every conservative posts. It wasn't any sort of breaking information. They weren't posting some sort of crazy propaganda that no one's ever heard of. The conservative Twitter was posting conservative videos that conservatives would like. They also ran an even bigger page on Facebook, which was a Black Lives Matter page, a black activist page called Blacktivist. And this page got so big, it was actually bigger than the actual Black Lives Matter pages. And there were pro-Muslim, pro-Sharia law, pro-LGBT pages. There were pro-Bernie Sanders pages. There were pro-Hillary Clinton pages. And there were pro-Trump pages. Arguably, the Hillary Clinton pages and the Blacktivist pages and the, you know, those type of pages were bigger than the Trump pages, and there was more money and, you know, influence in that direction. But it wasn't a one-sided thing. It wasn't the Russian government. This is just the facts. I mean, they're going to give you the big headline. They're going to give you the big name, the Nationals, and blah, blah, blah. If you want the big lie, you can go to any news organization. I'm sure they'll lie to you and try to push you in one direction. If you want the truth, here it is. I got it all, and I also worked in digital strategy, social media marketing, and I've worked at big agencies. I've worked on big projects with big clients, including, you know, big organizations, whatnot. So I have 8+ years of experience in digital marketing. I know exactly what the ads were, how much people they reached, and how big of a deal it actually is. So stay tuned, and we'll get into that. But the first thing is that they're just people from Russia. They're not part of the government. They're Russian nationals, which just means they're Russian. They're Russian people getting involved. The second thing to mention is they were all sorts of ads. So the influence was basically just, as Mueller and them say, they say it was to sow distrust among the United people. It was to sow division. So how did they sow division? They sowed division by posting exactly what Americans post. So there was no sort of mass effort to influence on one side. It was just a bunch of Russian trolls or Russian citizens stirring up the pot by doing what they do. I mean, the Blacktivist page posts the same thing that Vice posts. They post like they're Vox. They post just like American news outlets. They post the same exact content. The LGBT page posted what an LGBT American posted. The conservative pages posted what conservatives post. So there was in no way, shape, or form did this have any sort of big influence on the election. Hillary Clinton had a record-breaking $1.2 billion spent. $1.2 billion more than any candidate ever. 13 Russian citizens did not influence the election in any major way, shape, or form. Every single media source is going to try to spin it out of proportion and say that somehow Trump is involved in this. And the truth is, they were all sorts of ads. Trump had nothing to do with it. It influenced Trump for the better. It influenced Trump for the worse. It influenced Sharia law. Like, it did a bunch of things that had nothing to do with even pro-Trump stuff. There was a bunch of anti-Trump stuff. So he had nothing to do with this, and this just shows how far that they've gone. That they went from saying that he worked with Russia, literally collaborated with them. Now the big story is 13 Russian citizens posted on Facebook and Twitter. I mean, this just shows you how desperate they are and how they have nothing. I mean, if this is the best they can do, this is ridiculous. It's interesting. It's sad, and I also want to talk about how much influence they truly had. So, on the high end of it, Facebook said, and I covered this earlier, I'll cover it again. Facebook said that they had reached, I believe, around 121 million people. So, sounds like a lot of people, definitely, doesn't it? Like, whoa, every single Russian ad. And keep in mind, this isn't Russian government ads. These are just Russian people running advertisements on Facebook. So they put Facebook in a really weird spot, because Facebook is billions of people are on it. It's over a billion people. They work with every country. They accept advertising money and ads from every country. So now they put Facebook in a weird place that they're blocking ads from Russia when they have to do it to America. Whatever, but 121 million people reached is not that many people. I'll give you an example. It sounds like a lot of people. It's definitely a lot on the scale of, like, is it weak? No. It's decent and it's impressive, but for someone that worked in digital strategy and social media for 9 years and somebody that's involved in it now, I'll give you a comparison. During the 2016 election, someone was calling into my phone. During the 2016 election, I reached last year and probably in 2016 as well, a billion people. Between my two pages, I reached a billion people. On the high end, I reach 55 to 60 million people a week. On the low end, I reach 2 to 10 million people a week. So I had 10 times the amount of influence. Just me. Me with my cell phone and my computer, this and this, I reached 10 times as many people as all of the Russian citizens that they're freaking out about. I'm just being honest. They can act like it's the big scoop. They can act like it... had the biggest influence on the election. So if you're saying that these Russians influenced the election for President Trump, even though half of the ads were anti-President Trump and they were doing Black Lives Matter rallies that even Michael Moore himself attended. Yes, that's correct. Michael Moore attended a Russian-influenced rally by Russia, Russians. So if you're saying that that influenced the election, you're basically saying that I control the U.S. elections. Because if Russia influenced the election by reaching 120 million people, then did I control the entire election by reaching a billion people? I mean, it makes no sense. I reached 10 times as many people during the election cycle as all of the Russians combined, times 10, just me. Think about all the other people and all the other influence. Think about $1 billion of influence. So even on the high end of what they estimate that the Russians reached, it's not a big deal. I reach 10 times as many people. I have friends that work in social media that reach 10 times as many people, 20 times as many people with their clients. I mean, so do we control the United States election? Did we rig the whole election? I mean, it's ridiculous. So yes, they ran ads. No, they weren't all pro-Trump ads. There were a large portion of pro-Hillary and pro-activist and pro-Bernie Sanders ads. And no, it has no influence. It's not a big deal. It's such a small speck on the spectrum. And here's the most important thing that the media always misses. It's not about who says what. I don't care if a Russian citizen says it. I don't care if a United States politician says it, and Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton and President Trump. What are they saying? Is what they're saying true? Is it helpful? Is it honest? Is it accurate? This is how they get you. They paint it as, oh, they said this. Well, what are you saying? Because if you're a bigger liar than someone from Russia, like when Megyn Kelly had a debate with President Putin of Russia, Putin made Megyn Kelly look like a moron. Because she's an idiot. And she's like a United States propagandist who's so far out of touch with reality. And I'm sorry, I don't favor the Russia over the United States. I love America. I love the United States of America. I'm a citizen. I've never been to Russia. I don't know anything about Russia or their politics or their government. I know very little. But you don't win an argument by being like, you're Russian and I'm American. No, you have to tell the truth. And that's what the United States media doesn't understand. They don't tell the truth, and then they act like everything else is crazy. What was Russia saying? Were they telling the truth, or were they lying? Because when Putin talks to American journalists, he makes them look like the idiots that they are, because they're completely fanatical lunatics who will cover a story off of anything. Oh, they don't even have a source, and they'll cover it. Oh my God, Russia hacked the election. Do people not get it yet? I mean, do like they're going to act like this is, oh, they indicted Russians. Look, everyone, they indicted 13 Russians today. It means nothing. First of all, they have nothing to do with the President of the United States. Second of all, we're so fanatical, we're now indicting Russians for having an opinion on social media. Thirdly, their opinion influenced both sides of the election, and they literally ran ads that CNN runs themselves. When they run, you know, activist ads, CNN says, they're trying to sow division in America. So they're trying to sow division in America by covering the same topics that you cover, by posting the same things that you post, and by organizing events that you organize, and by posting like their Vox or Huffington Post or Vice. So that's how they're sowing mass confusion in America by literally doing what the mainstream media does. This is the story that they're telling. I'm not making this up. This is not my spin on it. This is literally what's happening. Most people are just so caught in the politics, they don't understand it. And what's very, very weird and hypocritical and should be blatantly obvious to pretty much anybody, if you have any sort of a brain, if you still control your brain and it functions without being a tool of, like, you know, the social media delusion. So they're indicting 13 Russians for posting on Facebook and running ads that don't even reach one-tenth of what I reach. Okay, so do they care about foreign influence, or do they care about this Russia narrative that they've pushed? Because what about how many Chinese people, how many people from China bought ads in the 2016 election? How many people from Qatar and Qatar and you know, Saudi Arabia and, you know, every single country ever, the United Kingdom, France, Germany, Poland, Hungary, Canada, Mexico, South America, like, how many people from other countries bought Facebook ads? How come we're stopping at Russia? Because they're not talking about the Russian government. They're saying they're Russian nationals. So Russian people, only Russian people can't post about the election. Okay. What, I mean, it makes absolutely no sense. They blocked RT, Russia television, from like Facebook and Twitter. You can't even post about it anymore. What about Al Jazeera? I mean, Google Al Jazeera or Wikipedia Al Jazeera. Who owns Al Jazeera? It's based on Qatar. It's Qatar's influence on the United States. So they're allowed to run rampant and say what Qatar wants to say and have Qatar influence on the United States. Al Jazeera, by the way, when you talk about all the Russian nationals reaching 100 million people, Al Jazeera reaches billions of people, billions. They probably reach billions weekly. So in a week, Al Jazeera probably reaches more people than every Russian citizen reaches in a year. But that doesn't matter. Why? Do we care about foreign influence? Do we care about Russian influence? Or do we just care about painting this narrative that Russia somehow influenced our election? Because it went from President Trump worked with Russia, Russia hacked the election, Russia changed the votes, to 13 Russian people posted on Facebook. Like, and this is the big scoop that CNN's going to run with, and NBC is going to run with, and New York Times, the Washington Post, and Vox, they're going to run with this. 13 Russians indicted for posting pro-Hillary and pro-Black Lives Matter and pro-conservative ads. Like, are you kidding me? What influence is this going to have on the world now? We're indicting foreign citizens for posting on social media. Do you see how this could possibly backfire in the United States, the country that literally funds moderate rebels in Libya and Syria, to physically overthrow a democratically elected president of a country, let alone all of the, you know, tens of countries that we've influenced, not only politically, socially, media-wise, but also physically? I mean, we arm every country with weapons, and then we think the big scoop is 13 Russians using Facebook and Twitter? I mean, this is embarrassing. This is what our law enforcement's doing? And then you wonder why there's a breaking AP report that the FBI had literal information that the shooter was going to shoot up the school and that he was a threat and that he had guns and he was planning to do it, and they didn't even investigate? Maybe because they're too busy making up this whole fake Russia narrative. They're too busy, you know, trying to spy on a democratically elected candidate rather than actually do their job. The law enforcement, and I'm not talking about all of the patriots and great people in the FBI, CIA, and the police force. You know, God bless you guys. I appreciate our law enforcement on every level doing the job that I personally, you know, couldn't do and don't do. So I have the utmost respect. I'm not a hater, and I'm not one of those like, oh, so I'm better than you because I sit on my couch. You know, I'm very grateful, very appreciative, and very honest and fair. But what is the FBI doing? What is Mueller's counsel doing? They're doing all this, oh, we're indicting third. That's the big scoop today. We just had, you know, someone shoot up a school and kill people on a preventable thing that they had a case on. And they're busy masquerading on the public saying, oh, don't worry, we got those 13 Russian citizens for posting on Facebook and Twitter, even though they reached 1/10 of this guy on the couch and that they reached like 1/1,000,000th of what Hillary Clinton spent. Like, it's like a piece of sand to a beach compared to all of the influence in the U.S. election. And they're going to put a microscope on that speck of sand just to make it the big scoop. And they do this with everyone. They put a microscope on, you know, the transgender community and act like everybody is that way. And no disrespect to transgender. I have much love and support. You know, do you. God bless. I'm not hating or judging in any way, but I'm saying that they always pick out a small portion of the percentage of the population and make it the big scoop. You know, they take a small portion of the Black community and they make it the big scoop. They take a small portion of the worst white people in the world and they make it the big scoop. They take the, you know, Latinos that they want to use for their agenda and make it the big scoop. They constantly do this. They put a microscope on stuff that isn't important, and it doesn't help. I mean, nothing about this is that cool. What about George Soros? George Soros spends billions of dollars. Let's take a look at George Soros. Billions of dollars to influence the United States election. spending billions of dollars to influence Brexit and trying to upend Brexit. Who is George Soros? He's a Hungarian Jewish man who isn't even welcome in his home country. Google Hungary, George Soros. He was born in Hungary, and they don't even want him there. They have a huge campaign in Hungary against George Soros because they're not idiots there. They're not brainwashed, delusional, slaves of the mainstream media like a lot of United States citizens are. They understand what's going on, so they're banning George Soros from running ads there because George Soros is somebody who influences election with billions of dollars. Not, oh, the Russians reached as much as Anomaly reaches in a week, and I don't even spend advertising money. I reach 10 times as many people as the Russians with no ad money. George Soros reaches 10 million times as many people as I do and influences elections on every single level, physically, mentally, spiritually, and financially. And the media won't cover it. You Google George Soros in American Western media and they say, he's the one percenter who's really helping the people. And, oh, don't question him. He's a Hungarian Jew. No disrespect to people of the Jewish religion. God bless you. I appreciate and respect the Jewish religion. But George Soros is a Hungarian Jew who's not welcome in Hungary, and he's not welcome in Israel. Israel banned him and didn't want his stuff influenced, and he said that they were anti-Semitic. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. George Soros said that Israel was anti-Semitic for not wanting him, and that Hungary is a big hate speech. He's not welcome in the two countries that he's, you know, his ethnicity's from. I mean, duh. But the American media won't tell you about that because he influences the American media. And it's not about who's saying what and who's doing it. What's the truth? I don't care if Russia's saying it. I don't care if George Soros is saying it. I don't care if Barack Obama's saying it. I don't care if Donald Trump's saying it. I don't care if CNN's saying it. I don't care if MSNBC's saying it. I don't care if Alex Jones says it. I don't care if Rachel Maddow says it. I don't care if the Young Turks say it. I don't care if Fox News says it. What's the truth? Let's stop talking about, oh, that's blah, blah, blah. That's what they do. Oh, that's propaganda. That's Trump said that. That's fake news. That's not real. That's blah, blah, blah. What's the truth? There's no regards for the truth. Everybody's just, oh, no, don't say that. That's Russian. What are they saying? Because either they're telling the truth or they're not. That's what's important. Not who's saying what. So to sum it up, 13 Russian nationals, which means they're citizens of Russia, they're not part of the government, at least according to the reports, they have been indicted by the Mueller Council, who instead of trying to stop school shooters, instead of, you know, monitoring domestic terrorists who are shooting up schools, they're indicting 13 Russians for running Facebook ads and posting on Twitter that had very, very small influence on a major scale. 10 times less influence than I have, a million times less influence than George Soros has, 10 million times less influence than Hillary Clinton's campaign had. They're indicting them. Only Russian citizens. They've never searched about Chinese. They've never, you know, China has one of the biggest influences on the United States, not only media sources, but they also on you know, the housing market and whatnot. There's wealthy Arabs. And there's wealthy Chinese and there's wealthy other people who come to the United States, buy up 10,000 apartments and then leave them empty. So when you go in your city and all the prices are skyrocketing high, it's because foreign nationals are coming to the United States and buying up millions of properties and leaving them empty because they have that much money. No one cares about that. They don't care about how high your rent is. They don't care about how high your taxes are because it's really not about you. It's about their agenda of trying to upend Trump and act like Russia's doing everything. You know, they don't care that Qatar owns Al Jazeera, which reaches billions of people weekly. They don't care that China has a massive influence on the United States, movie industry and mainstream media. They don't care that Saudi Arabian billionaires and possibly trillionaires, who knows how much money these guys have. My guess is they have 10 times as much money as Jeff Bezos. Jeff Bezos is the richest guy in the world. Yeah, I'm sure. A lot of these Saudi Arabian kings have trillions. They, you know, have stocks in Twitter, and they own, they're the largest shareholder in Twitter and in News Corp, which owns Fox with Rupert Murdoch. So it's like, okay, so Saudi Arabians can influence the news, and China can influence the news, and Qatar can influence the news, and UK can influence the news, and Piers Morgan can act like he's a conservative, but then he can share a whole fake article about the school shooter, even though he's Spanish, being a white supremacist. You know, that's UK influence. I mean, Piers Morgan reaches more people in a day than Russia reaches in 5 years, but it doesn't matter because the truth doesn't matter, accuracy doesn't matter, integrity doesn't matter, real journalism doesn't matter, safety doesn't matter, security doesn't matter, peace doesn't matter, love doesn't matter, unity doesn't matter. All that matters is pushing this nonstop story that white nationalists are taking over the world and everything is Trump's fault and Trump worked with Russia and Putin's the worst guy ever and he's destroying everything, even though, I mean, he did a lot more in Syria to actually help people than, you know, than Hillary and Obama did. I mean, you know, he's actually, like, helping keep the country together. Meanwhile, we're funding moderate rebels who are, you know, leaving complete power vacuums that are creating a refugee crisis, and then we're sending refugees to all these countries. I mean, it's a really sick, creepy, disgusting cycle. And I'm just very, very confused at how this is like a big scoop. So once again, just to sum it all up, 13 Russian nationals have been indicted for Facebook and Twitter posts. They're citizens of Russia. They're posting on Facebook and Twitter. Doesn't have one millionth of the reach of Americans or any other country. And no, Mueller, the FBI, and, you know, the United States press, they don't actually care about foreign influence. They don't care about China influence. They don't care about Saudi Arabia. They don't care about any other country of influence, or else they would be prosecuting people from all over the world, which would be ridiculous, because now if we're prosecuting everyone all over the world for posting on Facebook and Twitter about things that we don't want them to post on Facebook and Twitter, I mean, it's not going to go over well. Just like this is not going to go over well, because it's not to help you. It's not to make the election better. They're just trying to push this narrative that Russia had more of an influence than they did. And I urge you, if you don't agree with me, that's fine. Just think for yourself and feel free to read the articles. Feel free to read the indictments. They have the whole list of indictments up there. You can read it for yourself. See the evidence they have. See what they said. Everything I'm saying right now is incredibly accurate and, you know, not to talk myself up, but it's probably the most accurate report on the entire thing. I mean, you know, they're going to spin it this way. They're going to spin it this way. They're going to spin it this way. I gave you the facts. They did reach a lot of people. They had pro-Trump ads. They had pro-Hillary ads. They had pro-everyone ads. I told you what the news site's saying. I told you what the indictments are saying. And I told you who these people are. I mean, I told you how big of a deal it really was. I didn't tell you what I want you to think it is. Oh, it's a huge deal because that's what I want it to be. I mean, that's what it is. So tag somebody in it if you would like and just use this. Read for yourself and check out above the headline. Go into the meat of the article and you might just find out, even if you hate Trump and even if you're super liberal or you're super conservative, whatever, you might find out that once you get past the headline and you start reading, everything I'm saying is accurate and they're not trying to give you the truth. They're not trying to like educate you. They're not trying to keep foreign influence out of the election. They're trying to push their agenda and they're trying to make this story that Trump colluded with Russia so they have some sort of reason to upend him and put a puppet politician back in power. But they can't do it because after a year of fake news, all that's happened is backfire. We found out that the FBI was colluding with Obama, was colluding with Hillary to make up fake documents to spy on the president, and it's gone from Trump worked with Russia and they hacked our election to 13 Russian citizens posted on Facebook and Twitter. If that doesn't show you how desperate they are to push their narrative and how far it's fallen, I mean, there's a huge difference between they changed the election results and they changed the voting results to they just posted on Facebook. So it's going to be the big scoop. Everyone, oh, Mueller time. We're going to get Trump tomorrow. It's never going to come. All of these news sites are stringing you along for the big scoop. They're taking money from you. Oh, we're going to get him next week. We're going to get him next week. We're going to get him next week. You're watching a fake reality television show where they continuously string you along, use your emotions, use the fact that you hate Trump and you want to be a good person and you want to stop white supremacists, which we all should. I'm not saying that that's okay. But what I am saying is these news sites are using you, pretending like it's going to lead to something it's never going to lead to. It was never going to be Russia collusion. I told you this. I told my audience this in 2015. They're lying about the Russia stuff, and I've continuously been right, and the news has continuously been wrong. But they don't care, because they profit when they're wrong, and they continue to string people along on this non-existent fantasy Russian ride. They don't care. When are they gonna look at Saudi Arabia's influence and China's influence and Qatar's influence? They don't care about foreign influence. I'm sorry. I wish they did. Have a good day. That's enough for today. I'm kind of tired. I wasn't expecting for the double live stream, but it's a big story. I know a lot about it, and I already know the narrative that they're going to push is going to be loopy and just ridiculously inaccurate. So this is what it is. Thank you guys so much. I'm going to post my link below. Free email list. Sign up if you haven't. It's 5-10 seconds. I'll send you a monthly email of everything going on. Check out my donation link if you'd like to support. I'm also going to post dreamrare.com. I have shirts and hats and a new Truth Seeker shirt coming very, very soon. I'm going to post my YouTube link. Might even post my SoundCloud. I'm feeling froggy today. Let me know if you guys need anything else or any other links. I'll post my website as well, legendary.vision. If you'd like to book me for a podcast or a school or a convention or anything like that to speak, spirituality, positivity, I could speak about, not just politics, politics as well, obviously. But that's what it is. Have a good day. Have a good weekend. Tag somebody in this or share it. Let them know what the Russia collusion is and let them watch this. Let them debate. Let them research. It just is what it is. I think it's healthy to have a discussion, but these news sites are just pushing this story that just keeps falling so far. And I mean, these indictments are straight up just creepy and weird and just have no, it's not a big deal as far as U.S. elections and how much influence they really had. Thank you.